Hey, welcome to chapter one. I'm glad you picked up the book, and I hope you've read the full chapter ahead of the video. But if not, that's okay. We're going to go over some of the principles from the first chapter that we've talked about. Leadership is not just about position. Often, especially in the trades, I think we can assume that leadership is just about position. We go through, we get our tickets, we get the various certification that we need in order to practice our trades. And then we get put in a position of leadership. The problem is, leadership is a lot more than just position. We need the proper tools, the right tools for the right job, for the right role in leadership in order to be effective. It's just like anything else that we do. We need the correct tool for the right situation. I've got a row of hammers sitting here. They're different hammers for different reasons, for different... Hey, welcome to chapter one. I'm glad you picked up the book and made it this far. Now, chapter one, if you've read it, you understand we're just kind of introducing the topic of leadership. Leadership is easy to misunderstand. Often we assume that leadership is simply about position. I've been put in a position of leadership, and so I'm a leader. And people should just listen to me and do what I need them to be doing. That's usually not how things work. I want to give you a little bit of an example of what it takes to be a leader and what this book is going to do for you. I've got a row of hammers in front of me here. I think there's six of them, and they're all for different jobs. They're for different responsibilities that we're going to carry out, and they represent different tools that we need for leadership. It's not just about one tool. And the name of the book is More Than a Hammer, because often it's the assumption that we just need one tool and we can be a good leader. I just need to be able to hit people on the head, or I just need to be able to threaten or make people feel intimidated enough and they're going to follow me. Or I just need to be their friend and then they're going to listen to what I need them to do and they're going to put their heart into it and give me their best. And I'm going to hardly really never need to correct them. The reality is leadership is much more in depth than that. It's a little bit, quite a bit more complicated many times. And if you've been a leader for any length of time, you know what I'm talking about. There's different hammers here. This one is for fixing dents in auto body. So a vehicle comes in, and this helps hammer out the dents. Ball peen hammer for totally different role. We've got a dead blow hammer here. We've got a framing hammer. Then we've got a nailer here, a brad nailer. Just had a mind blank right there. We've got a brad nailer here for finishing work. And then lastly, I have a sledgehammer. These are all the same type of tool. They're all hammers of one sort or another. They're all meant for hitting or inserting a nail or something into another object. Or in the case of a sledgehammer, for breaking something apart, and the framing hammer as well. But they're not used interchangeably. None of these hammers really can be used in place of the other. For a specific job, we need a specific hammer. And it's the same in leadership. We need specific tools and to know how to use those tools in order to be effective in specific situations in leadership. And that's what this book is going to do for you. I'm going to give you some very specific tools to help you become a more effective leader and more effective at what you do in your everyday work world. Now, it's not going to be simply how do you take people from here to here. This first book, we're going to be working on you. This is where I had a start too. I tried to jump ahead and I tried to just be a leader and I focused on here's what I need people to do and I got to get them to do it. And I forgot to develop myself first. And I had to go back and I had to start over and I had to develop myself. I had to develop certain skills in order for me to lead myself effectively before I could lead somebody else. And the first few videos are going to take place in here. It's an unfinished mezzanine in a shop. And it's right in the middle of some construction. And it's fitting for what we're going to be talking about. So I hope to see you in chapter two. Look forward to it. Talk to you then. Bye-bye.